Reading the writings of victims of human rights violations. 'Tis about the coupling when we are born. We receive guidance from our parents, grandparents, and family members at all times. Then the church and the school. We learn that only God is an omniscient and omnipresent being in our lives, but that he never disrespects or violates us. We learned that a woman has the right and freedom to have a husband and start a family with him, but each one exercising their freedom. We learned that for there to be love, there must be respect and free discernment and understanding on both sides. The marginal system that imprisons hundreds of people around the world is a new God different from our God, the true God. The marginal system established a new order within the doctrines of all churches and religions. The changes in the doctrines of our ancestors are suffering extreme violence and adulteration in their teachings, usages and customs, with many arguments coming from sciences like parapsychology, psychology and psychiatry. Within the new order, to which the churches and the state are silent, it allows and inflicts slavery and the total submission of human beings to their tutors. Who are the mentors who act without physical presence or risks, injuring and submitting their victims, imprisoned, and they have their rights totally violated by the criminal organization. Marriage has been replaced by mating, connection. They are hideous ways of submitting, forcing, raping a woman or man who does not want to submit to a certain person who is part of the system. And this marginal system uses people, victims, through experimentation, selling or sexual advantages, and even memorial acts on victims, hiring and going crazy. When the marginal system couples a victim to a rapist, a torturer user, the victim is totally unable to defend himself, the victim and the rapist start to neurophysically occupy the same body. He doesn't have it unless he takes his own life, and this induction by sexual imposition and torture is classified as induction to suicide by the Brazilian Penal Code. The victim, when eating, touches his own lips because they are not her own, but those of those who are connected to her, for the total apprehension of her senses and abusive, sexual and experimental practices of all kinds. When the victim goes to wash his private parts in the shower, it is not the hands that wash them, but the hands of the torturer to feel the victim and violate his intimacy. The victim has his body touched, his intimate regions, and suffers violent rapes at any time and in any place, suffering organic consequences of all kinds. Which is why the non-participation of the medical profession is totally disregarded. Very strong injury suffered by the victim is that of being touched by rapists, disgust, repulsion. It damages the gastric system, ulcerating the gastric mucosa, and with risks of evolution to gastritis and ulcers. The rapists. The perpetrator's conviction that he is totally accepted by the woman as part of the torture techniques, they rape men, women or children, and because of the sounds they produce. Through their speeches, the torturers defraud what is happening as if, at that moment, nothing was happening. The speeches of rapists and criminals with groups. The audiences present with the certainty that the victim accepts them and is saying yes to the violence committed against them, victims. There are books like Mind Control that teach people to relax and close their eyes, imagining scenes they would like to happen in their lives. This torture tactic is based on this teaching of parapsychological science in reverse. Instead of the person of their own free will to lie down, relax and imagine scenes of whatever happens in their life, this marginal system makes the rapist's rapist meditation occur through coupling. They pay the system. And there are victims to imagine feeling in the flesh of the same, coupled to it, and inflicting all sorts of unimaginable tortures. And releasing moans and speeches as if you were having sex with yourself consented. Torturers destroy any and all principles, changing their real configurations through interpretations that legalize criminal practices. justify criminal practices and form new jurisprudence by criminal organization, invading the authority of the judiciary, they treat this power as if it were above it. By their own standards, which are granted to them as state power, and if approached, insist on proving that nothing happens in moments of terrible rape, in which many victims scream. Run around the house, call the police and doctors, but when they arrive at the scene they are not convinced and withdraw, leaving the place and the victim in a situation of doubt about their mental health. I leave these truths here so that they can be said, shared, and that the churches know that all this is true and are working to distance man from the true God, closing churches through pandemics. This will not be the last. Isolating men from family and spiritual support are strategies that facilitate the processes of inducing the various triggers that this criminal organization that operates with very advanced technologies takes advantage of. If the churches and communities do not unite and start to discuss the matter, verify forms of defenses and precisions, and ostensible spiritual policing, and to really reinforce everyone, the Third World War could break out around religious and apolitical issues. This organized crime and these perpetrators, criminal mentors, covertly act to prevent victims from suffering the benefit of justice because sciences such as psychiatry insist that none of this exists, I've never heard of it, and that the victims are with mental problems. This is the great world order that neither church nor state can win against, considering that high political, military and religious figures use the system for different purposes and it is extremely profitable. I ask for anonymity in relation to my writings.